Python if statements, everything you need to know, with examples, a quiz, the answers to the quiz, and all the code repeated at the end. There's about 7 minutes of video about if statements and a couple of minutes of Booleans. The rest of the video is the quiz questions and the answers and the code repeated at the end. Okay, we're going to cover the different if statements and Booleans. So you might have heard of conditionals. What does this mean? It's code that's based on a condition. So the condition is going to be either true or false, which is a Boolean. So the example would be an if statement. So you check the condition to see if it's true, and if it's true, you action the code. So in this example, you would print X. So you check X is 1, which is true, so it prints X. In the other example, the condition is false, so you don't print X. So if we look at the if statement, there's certain parts. It starts with the word if. Then we have the condition, checks X equals 1. Then we have a colon, and then we have the code underneath. And notice there's a gap. It doesn't start at the beginning. This is called an indentation. So if we look at two if statements, one written correctly and one with an error, you can see the first one has the if statement and then there's a gap at the beginning of the print statement. So that tells us that print statement's part of that if statement, if you like. So if the condition is true, it will do that print statement. The second one, there's no space, there's no indentation, so that will create an error. You can see the first one has the correct indentation, the second example, there's no space, so therefore you will receive an error message. So this indentation isn't necessarily just one line of code, it tells us which code we should do if the if statement's true. So here we have an example where there's two print statements, and in the first example, both will only happen if the if statement condition is true. The second example, the first line will happen if the if statement is true, but the second line hasn't got an indentation. So that will happen if the if statement is condition is true or false. We normally use symbols like the equals equals and not equals symbols, greater than or smaller than. But in Python, you can use the word is. This can also be used with is not. So in this example, we can see we have used the word none. So sometimes you don't want to use zero because you might have smaller numbers or larger numbers. So you want something that doesn't really give a value. So you can use this keyword none that has no value. In this example, we've got if X is none, print X, which is X has a value, so there's no output. And in the second example, we've got is not none, so that would print out X because it has a value, which is not none. With strings, you have to remember that it's case sensitive. So the first example, X equals O-N-E, the string, so that will print. And in the second example, it doesn't print anything because the O-N-E is lowercase while X has an uppercase O. So the condition is false, so it has no output. So we can use different mathematical symbols. We can have equals to equal signs, not equal to, greater than, less than, greater than, or less than. So here's some examples of not equal to 1, so print 2, which is X, and X is greater than or equal to 1, which is also true, so that will also print 2, which is X. Be careful with greater than or equal to and less than or equal to. If you get the symbols the wrong way around, then you'll get a syntax error. So be careful here. We've got the equals and a less than sign the wrong way around. So we looked at the if statement, and that actions are code if the if statement, the condition is true. What happens if it's false? Well, you can action that code if you use an else statement. So for example, here x equals 1, the condition, does x equal 1? Yes, so that will print x. But if x did not equal 1, then it would print 0. So we have a true or false situation. So in the second example, we have a false situation. So the if statement is not true, so the else part, which prints 0, will happen. We can put if statements inside other if statements, and these are called nested ifs or nested if statements. So here we have an if else statement inside another if else statement. So what this code does is it checks to make sure x doesn't equal 0. If it does, it will print 0 as part of the else. If it doesn't equal 0, then we just check to see if it's greater than 0, it's positive, or less than 0, negative. So that's the nested if. An alternative to achieve the same thing would be use an if, an elif, and an else. So we have to start with an if statement. You can finish with an else statement, but in between, if you want any more conditions, you use elif. So in this example, if x is greater than 0, it's positive. If it's less than 0, it's negative. And if it's neither of them two, then it must equal 0. Now we move on to Booleans. A Boolean is a data type, and it can have the value of true or false. So we can use it in a condition. The condition is either true or it's false. So in an if statement, if the condition is true, the code will action. So in this example, m will be printed. In the second example, the condition is false, so nothing's printed, there's no output. So here's some examples of true conditions. 1 equals 1, 2 is greater than 1, 3 is less than 4. And other conditions that are false. 1 not equal to 1 is false, 2 less than 1, and 3 greater than 4. These are false. So we use this Boolean logic. We can actually put more than one condition together, but both of them need to be true if we use AND. If we use OR, then only one of the conditions needs to be true. And we can change it, so instead of something to be true, we can use NOT, and that will change the condition from true to false or false to true. So we can see in these examples. The first example, we use AND. Both conditions are true, so it prints the values. In the second one of the conditions is not true. So with the AND, that means that it won't print. With the OR, we only need one of the conditions to be true. The first example, both were true, so it happens. The second one, it also happens. It prints X and Y because one of the conditions is true. And the last example, we have AND NOT. So the first if statement, both conditions are true. So that actually turns it around, because we want not Y not to equal 1. So there's no output. And then in the second example, X equals 1, which is true, and Y does not equal 2. So that will print. So the AND NOT reverses the Y equals 2. So the answers to these questions are all if statements, and you might want to test your code by using different values for testing. So for example, x equals 0 and x equals 1 to see if the condition is true or false. Question 1, I want you to print yes if D equals easy, and oh no if D, the string D, equals hard. That's question 1. Question 2, you've got X and Y, and X and Y can be either 0 or 1. If they're both 0, print both are 0. If they're both 1, print they both are 1. If Y is 0, print only y is 0, and if x is 0, only x is 0. So that's question 2. Question 3, you've got a playing card. So card equals 10, for example. In this if statement, if the card equals 7, we're going to print the character 7. If it's lower than 7, print the word lower, and if it's higher, print the string higher. That was question 3. Question 4, we're going to decide to play tennis. So we're going to either print play or not play. And the decision is based on if it's raining, yes or no, or if it's too hot or cold, yes or no, Y or N. So if it's not too hot or cold and it's not raining, we play. Otherwise, we not play. That was question 4. Okay, question 5 looks a bit complicated, but we're looking to see if you can play a game or not. So there's some criteria, there's some rules. So to play, you have to be over 18. If you're not over 18, you need parent permission. To play, you have to be a resident, but not an employee. So all of these rules must be met for you to play the game, which means you can print OK. Otherwise, you print not OK. That was question 5. Okay, let's go through the answers. So question 1, we wanted to print yes if D equals easy, and oh no if D equals hard. We just write an if statement with if D equals the string easy, then print yes, else print oh no. So that was question 1. Question 2, we're going to print either both are 0, both are 1, if x and y are the same value, or if only x is 0, we print that, and if only y is 0, we print that, depending on if x or y equals 0. So here we have if-else statements inside or nested in one big if-else statement. So we've got if x equals 0, and then we've got if y equals 0 or not 0, and else means if x equals 1, we've got the same, if y equals 0, y equals 1. This means that if x equals 0, we're going to either print both are 0 or only x is 0, or using the else part of the if statement, if x equals 1, then we're going to print only y is 0, or both are 1. So I hope you understand that. That was the answer to question 2. Question 3, we chose a card number. If it equals 7, we print 7. If it was lower, we print lower. If it was higher, we print higher. So this is an if, elif, else statement. So you can do this several ways, but here, if the card equals 7, print 7. Less than 7 in the elif statement, prints lower, else if it's neither of these two, it's going to be higher. That was the answer to question 3. Question 4 was the one that we decided if we was going to play tennis or not, depending if it was raining or if it was hot or cold. So here we've used the and word, so we've got the condition that it's not raining and it's condition that it's not too hot or cold, and we play, print play, else we don't play. So there are different ways of doing this, so you could change this to use and not rather than not equals. You can see that down the bottom. That was the answer to question 4. Now question 5 was a bit complicated. It was checking several rules to see if you could play a game, and the rules were if you had to be over 18, be a resident, can't be an employee, and if you're under 18 you would need parents' permission. So that seems quite a lot, and the answer here, we've got If employed does not equal yes and resident does equal yes, then we check to see if someone is either over 18, yes, or the parent permission equals yes. So if all of that's true, we print OK. So if the second statement's false, we print not OK. And if the first statement is not true, the conditions are not met, we also print not OK. So that was the answer to question 5. Well, if you want to print a comment, please do so. Please subscribe. The question here is, can you think of an if statement that doesn't work? You've tried something, but you're not sure how it works. Perhaps if you put that in the comments, we can reply with a solution. Okay, thank you for watching and enjoy. Here's the code again.